Welcome back to SnowRunner on Hard Mode. At the end of the last episode, we completed the Lumber Mill Revival contract, which gives us access to an additional source of wooden planks on the Island Lake map. I plan to complete the Power Lines contract in this episode, but there are three wooden bridges which also need to be built, so let's load up the White West and start with planks so we can complete some of those along the way. Next, I'll send the Fleet Star ahead to deliver the first load of metal beams to the Fallen Pole for the Power Lines contract. Before completing the rest of the contract, we'll need to organise a fuel supply. Thankfully, there are several fuel carriers on the Island Lake map, and there is one nearby we can collect. We'll be right back. Now we can switch back to the White Western Star and deliver two loads of wooden planks for the Bridge the Gap task. With the bridge complete, the easiest way to turn the truck around is to take a lap around the drilling site. We can now deliver the next two loads of planks to the North Bridge to complete the tough negotiations task. Again, the easiest method to turn around is to go around the drilling site. With the first two bridges complete, we can take the Fleet Star and the fuel trailer to the logging station, which will give us access to more metal beams to repair the last two fallen poles, and the wooden planks for the last bridge we need to build on this map. The Fleet Star is really out of its element here, especially while towing the fuel carrier, but this little truck has not once let me down in this playthrough so far, and I'm thoroughly impressed with how well it's done. Thank you. We need to load some more metal beams. Note that in some of these loading bays which are on soft ground, the Fleetstar's crane anchors don't fully stabilise the truck while the bed is empty. Let's jump back in the White Western Star and bring it across to the logging station. We'll need one more load of metal beams and two loads of wooden planks. Note how the Fleetstar now seems more stable using the crane on the soft ground with some extra weight on board. We can now deliver the metal beams to the second fallen pole for the power lines contract. Next stop is to load the cargo container from the fallen antenna, which can later be delivered as part of the broken antenna task. There doesn't seem to be a way to manually load the cargo container with the crane, so in this case we'll have to take the $150 hit and load it automatically. Before we take the White Western Star any further, I'll run the final load of beams to the last fallen pole in the Fleet Star and complete the power lines contract. Now that the power lines contract is complete, let's jump back in the White Western Star and deliver two loads of planes to the South Bridge to complete the corporate expansion task. When the truck stopped dead here, I thought I hadn't left enough space and the trailer had caught the pole, but it actually was hung up on one of the fallen trees. Thankfully, it let go after rocking back and forth a few times, but these can sometimes cause erratic behaviour if you're unlucky. We've now completed all the bridge building tasks on Island Lake and we've reached rank 12. I'll leave it here for this episode. Thanks for watching.